So this is the second technique of integration, and this is called the u-substitution. I will just call this as a u-sub. So what is u-sub? Well, back in the days, when we were doing derivative, we have the chain rule, right? And now I'm going to show you guys the connection between the u-sub and the chain rule. Let's focus on this one right here. We are going to first take the derivative of tangent of x to the fourth power. So how can we do that? Well, we have to remember, what is the derivative of tangent first? Derivative of tangent is secant squared, right? And then the inside function right here is x to the fourth power. We keep it to be the same for now. So we have secant squared, and then the inside stays the same. So secant squared, x to the fourth power, right? And the chain rule tells us that we have to look at the inside function, which is x to the fourth power. We have to multiply by the derivative of the inside function. Derivative of x to the fourth power is 4x to the third power, right? So we have to multiply this by 4x to the third power. That's the chain rule. And this right here is it. That's the derivative for tangent of x to the fourth power. At the end, we usually write down this part first. 4x to the third power, and then write down the secant squared, x to the fourth power, and this is it. We don't need to put a plus e, this is just the derivative. Okay, so how can we integrate 4x to the third power secant squared of x to the fourth power dx? I know you guys see what I'm doing right here, but I want to show you guys all the steps, okay? To integrate something, we have to ask ourselves, do we know right away derivative of what function give us this? Assume we did not do this question, okay? So that way I can write down the whole steps for you guys. And this way I can introduce you guys the way that how the u-sub works and then the steps of the things that we should write down. Okay, so here is the thought process. I don't technically know the derivative of what function will give me this right away, right? Because the derivative table doesn't have this as one of the entry. So this is how we are going to do it. You see that we have secant squared and then the inside is x to the fourth power. And imagine if you have to take the derivative. This part here is usually the part that requires the chain rule, right? In that case, that's the candidate for the u. This right here, x to the fourth power, what I'm going to do first is I'm going to set this to be the u. And this is the procedure. This is the step of the things that we'll write down. We usually let u equals to the inside function. In this case, is the x to the fourth power. And once again, u is usually the part that requires the chain rule. If you imagine this was the derivative, right? Okay, u is equal to x to the fourth power. And what we have to do next is we have to talk about the derivative of this. So let's differentiate both sides. And we'll just talk about the differential. Because usually, you can write this down as, okay, differentiate, we get du dx. It's equal to 4x to the third power, right? However, I'm going to just write down this for you guys. So this way we can save one step. Talk about the differential-wise, on the left-hand side, when you differentiate, we just get du. On the right-hand side, we do the usual power rule. We have 4x to the third power, but then we have the dx, okay? So that's the differential part. Anyways, what I would like you guys to do next is, we would like to isolate the dx. So we can look at this equation and divide both sides by 4x to the third power. This way, we can get dx equals to du will be on the top over this 4x to the third power. And this is the things that I like to tell my students. This original integral is in the x world because the dx says so. What we're going to do is, we will take this integral from the x world into the u world. Let me show you. So this is going to be integral. This right here, well, it's just 4x to the third power. I would like to just write it down as how it is for now. Secant squared, that's a function part, so I will just write down secant squared. However, for the inside, this is x to the fourth power, and we set that to be u. So we just put this down as u right here. And we also have the dx. Don't forget the dx. This is crucial when we're doing integration. Dx in the u world is du over 4x to the third power. So let's put it down right here. Du over 4x to the third power. So what do we have to do next? You see, this right here, we have 4x to the third power, and then we are also dividing by 4x to the third power. Of course, they cancel each other out, precisely, right? At the end, what we'll have is integral of secant squared u du. And you see, originally, the integral was in the x world. Everything was in terms of x, right? And now, this integral is in the u world. We have secant squared u only that we have to worry about, right? And this is the idea. After we have done the u substitution, this integral right here is something that we can recognize from the derivative table. We have to ask ourselves, derivative of what will give us secant squared u? Well, the answer for that will be tangent u, isn't it? And at the end, we are done with the integration. However, we do have to go back to the x world because right here, we know u, right, is equal to x to the fourth power. And originally, you know, fundamentally, the question was in the x world. So let's go back. At the end, tangent of x to the fourth power. And we are done. Usually, I just like to tell my student, after we are completely done with the integral, we put a plus c at the very end, okay? You don't need to worry too much about putting a plus c right here. It doesn't really matter that much. So, what is the connection between the chain rule and the u sub? The chain rule is that when we are taking the derivative, we have to multiply by the derivative of the exact function. The u sub is that we have to divide it by the derivative of the exact function, right? And you see, when we divide it by the derivative of the exact function, this is something that we can recognize. And I do want to make a remark. Sometimes there are integrals that we just cannot work out. And usually, when we are doing the questions from the textbook, those are the questions that definitely can work, right? So once again, this is how the u sub will work. And I'm going to show you guys the next example. Okay, let's once again look at integral and then the derivative question side by side. But this time, we'll look at the integral first. So we have to integrate 1 over 5x minus 2 dx. And do we know the derivative of what function will give us exactly 1 over 5x minus 2 right away? Maybe it's not too obvious, right? And this is where the u sub can help us out. And you see, right here, we have 5x minus 2 in the denominator. If I differentiate 5x minus 2, I get just a 5, which is just a number, right? And that would be a good choice for u. Let me show you how it works. So let u equals to 5x minus 2, just the denominator. And then when you differentiate both sides, differential-wise, okay? On the left-hand side, we have du on the right-hand side. The derivative of 5x minus 2 is just the 5. This is 0. And don't forget to put down the dx. And I like to tell my students, isolate the dx. So let's divide by 5 on both sides. Then we can get dx equals to du on the top over 5. If you isolate the dx like this every time, it's easier to see, do you need to multiply, or do you need to divide, what will cancel, or things like that. Okay, so I highly recommend you guys to isolate the dx like this. Anyways, we are ready to take this integral from the x world into the u world. So we have the integral right here. 1 on the top over 5x minus 2 is the u. So we put down the u in the denominator. Dx is du over 5. So put that down, du over 5. All right, so a few things that we can do here and there. First, you see we do have a factor 1 over 5 right here, isn't it? We can take a constant multiple outside of the integration. So I can look at this as 1 over 5 integral of 1 over u, and then we have the du. And now we see, what's the integral of 1 over u du? Derivative of what will give us 1 over u? The answer to that is natural log of u, right? And we are done with the integration part, you see. Don't forget to write down the constant multiple 1 over 5. And this gives us ln u. And remember, whenever we go from the integral of 1 over u du to this, we have to attach an absolute value around the u. And why do I have to do that? You can check out my previous video on that. But anyways, attach the absolute value, and then we are kind of done with the integration part. At the very end, take the u back to the x. So we have 1 over 5 ln absolute value. The u is 5x minus 2. So let's put that down right here for u. Close it. At the end, we are done. So we put a plus c at the end. This is it. This is the answer for that integral. And now I will have to ask you, what if we differentiate this right here? And that's exactly this part of the question. So let's go ahead and differentiate 1 over 5 ln of 5x minus 2. And notice that for the derivative equation, the absolute value is not needed. We will just focus on the parentheses. But then when you integrate, be sure you have the absolute value. All right, so to take the derivative of this, this is just a constant multiple, so we can write that down right away, 1 over 5. And we'll just focus on the derivative of this part right here. This is the function part. Derivative of ln of something is what? This will give us 1 over this thing, which is 5x minus 2. And then you see the inside is 5x minus 2, isn't it? Chain rule says we have to take the derivative of this, which will give us 5, and then multiply right here. So we multiply by 5. And you see, this is why I chose u to be 5x minus 2. U sub and chain rule, they are related. U sub is just pretty much the backwards version of the chain rule. So this part right here is the chain rule. This part here, what's the u sub? You see? At the end, you have 1 over 5 times this times 5. What happens? 1 over 5 and 5 cancels each other out. Well, we have just 1 over 5x minus 2. We are done. So you see, they confirm with each other. U sub and chain rule.
That's it.
And you should check out my next video. I'll work on more examples and the trickier ones for you guys.